back to Hannity. So a good friend of the show, Sheriff David Clarke, he made waves when he called out the hypocrisy of the mainstream media over fake news, tweeting, quote, "Fake news was born in August 2014 in Ferguson, Missouri, when the MSNBC, mainstream media, the New York Times, Washington Post, CNN all propagated the hands up, don't shoot lie." Now, here are just a few examples that he mentioned. Take a look.
Outrage in Ferguson, Missouri today after police shot and killed an unarmed teenager Saturday afternoon in broad daylight.
The kid body jerked as if he was hit from behind, and he turned around and he puts his hands up like this, and the cop continued to fire until he just dropped down to the ground and his face just smacks the concrete.
So when he turned and faced him and put his hands up, was he standing still at that point?
Yes.
Thousands of Americans are marching in New York and Washington and across the country demanding a justice system that applies the same to everybody and honors our values. And you, we want you to know that our hearts are out there marching with them.
Oh, they all had their hands up. Don't shoot. All this began when the mainstream media took the word of Michael Brown's friend when he gave his version of the shooting that day back in 2014. Watch this.
His weapon was already drawn when he got out the car. He shot again, and once my friend felt that shot, he turned around and he put his hands in the air, and he started to get down, but the officer still approached with his weapon drawn, and he fired several more shots, and my friend died.
Joining us now, Milwaukee County Sheriff David Clarke, trial attorney, political commentator Eric Guster. That was the guy that was with Michael Brown, Sheriff, when he robbed and intimidated the clerk before they were confronted by the police officer. Isn't that true? And then the media took that lie and they ran with it without any fact checking. There were a number of people in the trial that ended up, or when they had the grand jury, that ended up saying, didn't happen that way. They said he charged the officer. He engaged the officer, tried to take the officer's gun. And that's why Darren Wilson was never indicted, right?
Well, it's why I said, Sean, that fake news has a birthplace and a birth day, August 9th, 2014, when this widely held false belief of hands up, don't shoot was propagated by the media. They went down there and fit their narrative. Think about what happened off that fake news, Sean. It changed America. This anti-police sentiment rose out of this. This, what I call the bastard child of hands up, don't shoot, Black Lives Matter, grew out of this thing. It swept the country. There are people to this day, Sean, who believe that Mike Brown had his hands up and was walking away with his back turned to Darren Wilson when Darren Wilson shot and killed him. In fact, we all know that's a lie. And only one Washington Post writer had the character, had the integrity to admit that it was a lie. I think it was Jonathan Capehart is his name, who wrote an op-ed and said, yeah, we got hoodwinked on that thing. It was embarrassing for this industry, and he had the courage to do it. But to this day, no other media outlet has done it.
No, Eric, you do know that that never happened, right? You're not arguing that hands up, don't shoot actually happened, are you?
I'm not arguing that hands up, don't shoot ever happened.
Because
but what
did.
David Clarke is trying to, no, it did not happen. But what David Clarke is saying is the dumbest thing I've heard on TV since Florida said they were going to be Bama. What he's claiming is the hands up, don't shoot movement was the beginning of fake news sites. The Onion was started in 1988,
that's
which is the premier fake news
Eric,
site.
Eric,
well,
that's a satire site.
It is fake. It is a fake news site,
okay,
that some people think is real.
But in a serious sense, that false narrative was perpetrated by NBC, by ABC, by CBS, by CNN, by the New York Times. And
they came out and said it was a lie.
Hang on a second. And irresponsibly, they advanced a narrative where people were regurgitating it. And then as a result, a certain expectation was raised. And then when the black eyewitnesses testified before that grand jury, it wasn't the outcome that people expected. And what happened, Eric? As a result of their irresponsible reporting, what happened?
A lot of people fell for that. But all those media
what
sites,
happened?
All those NBC, MSNBC, all of those sites,
CNN,
all those stations came out and said, all of them did. They said that that was a lie. I've said it was a lie. So let's
I
not.
I don't remember
play,
them saying it was a lie. That,
that
they. I don't remember
yes, they
a
did.
Big apology saying we were wrong and we falsely reported hey, from a guy that robbed up
Sean,
a store and intimidated a clerk, Sheriff Clarke.
They did say that was not true. They did. No, let me finish. They did say that was not true. And for you to say, for Clarke to claim that that was the beginning of fake news is the most ridiculous thing.
Sheriff Clarke. Sheriff, you want to respond?
Well, it's fine. It might be ridiculous, but I'll tell you what. We have dead cops because of that hands up, don't shoot lie. We had two in New York. We also had five in Dallas. And some in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, people who were trying to avenge for the life of Mike Brown, who was a thug. Here's another thing they left out
and
of that story.
Been 11
Mike
cops
Brown
killed
had just strong-armed a convenience store clerk who was half his size. That is a felony in every state in America. And he also tried to disarm a law enforcement officer. That's how serious this was. It might sound dumb to you, but there are dead cops because of that fake news story out of Ferguson, Missouri. And Eric, I resent that. Coming from you.
No, your theory is dumb. Someone attacking cops is a personal thing to me. I do not want anyone
then
to
maybe
assault,
you then,
harm,
oh,
or
then
kill
Eric,
cops.
Then don't and make why, irresponsible why comments from the media that suggest something that never, excuse me, they advanced a false narrative, a lie. And as a result of the lie, people believed it. And a certain expectation increased in people in terms of what the outcome would be as a result of the lie that it was all predicated on. That's
but
the problem.
The truth is,
Eric,
no, the truth
Eric,
is,
let me help
Ferguson,
you out here. The only people
Ferguson,
who believe
no,
the
no,
onion
in
Ferguson, liberals because
there were
liberals
many,
don't
many
critically
cases
think
of African Americans being
susceptible
stopped,
to nonsense,
being
and all they can do is
and the
parrot
civil,
talking.
And the civil rights
last word,
division.
Sheriff.
No, the Civil Rights Division
last
stated
was,
that.
Last
that was,
word, Sheriff. Let the sheriff have the last word.
Fine. Thank you, Sean. Again, fake news, you know, most people can figure it out. It might last a day or two, but the hands up, don't shoot fake news out of Ferguson, Missouri continues to this day. And cops are still being killed across this country based off of that fake news story.
All right. We got to leave it there.
That's
thank you. Both.